Step to Christ, the privilege of prayer. Keep your wants, your joys, your sorrows, your cares, and your fears before God. You cannot burden Him, you cannot weary Him. He who numbers the hairs of your head is not indifferent to the wants of His children. The Lord is very pitiful and of tender mercy. James chapter 5. Verse 11. His heart of love is touched by our sorrows and even by our utterances of them. Take to Him everything that perplexes the mind. Nothing is too great for Him to bear, for He holds up worlds, He rules over all the affairs of the universe. Nothing that in any way concerns our peace is too small for Him to notice. There is no chapter in our experience too dark for Him to read. There is no perplexity too difficult for Him to unravel. No calamity can befall the least of His children, no anxiety harass the soul, no joy cheer, no sincere prayer escape the lips of which our Heavenly Father is unobservant or in which He takes no immediate interest. He healeth the broken in heart, and bindeth up the wounds. Psalm 147, verse 3. The relations between God and each soul are as distinct and full as though there were not another soul upon the earth to share His watch care, not another soul for whom He gave His beloved Son. Jesus said, "Ye shall ask in My name, and I say not unto you that I will pray the Father for you, for the Father Himself loveth you. I have chosen you, that whatsoever ye shall ask of the Father in My name, He may give it you." John chapter 16, verse 26 and verse 27, and chapter 15, verse 16. But to pray in the name of Jesus is something more than a mere mention of that name at the beginning and the ending of a prayer. It is to pray in the mind and spirit of Jesus while we believe His promises, rely upon His grace, and work His works. Step to Christ, page 100.